G'day my gorgeous goblins, welcome back to Darkwood Fantasy Creatures. My name's Aileen. And this project started out as a meme, but it might just be unironically one of the best things I've ever made. By now I'm sure we've all heard the sound going around on the internet and seen its association with the majestic worm on a string that is the Borzoi. And with the rise of the popular ARG found footage series The Mandela Catalogue, content involving biblically accurate angels has really been popping off over on TikTok, so I decided to combine the two. Psst, you should also really go check out my friend Miss Twisted's work, she's incredible. But yeah, it was either this or a Five Nights at Freddy's doll. As per usual, I start with a ball of tin foil as my base, and I mold cosplay sculpt over top into the shape that I want. To give the illusion of enamel for the teeth, I just mix some white sculpy clay with some translucent, and I think it worked out alright. Now for the detail sculpting. Lots and lots of detail sculpting. And because I apparently like hurting myself, I decided to detail sculpt the paws as well, rather than just covering them with fur like I normally do. Thank you. And speaking of hurting myself, I also hand-sculpted and painted about a bajillion eyes and narrowly avoided burning myself several times sculpting wings out of warbler thermoplastic. And with it finally all sculpted, I used two-part epoxy sculpt to attach them to the head, and then impaled him with a tiny sword. Now for paint! Using a mix of acrylic paint cut with water and some fine brushes, I painted his head and paws to kind of resemble clouds, and his wings to look like the sun in the sky. And of course, I gloss everything that needs glossing, and his nails also get a manicure. Now, with the paint job all done, it's time for my favourite part, the decorating. I have a large collection of shinies to choose from, and with some careful consideration and a lot of restraint on my part to not use everything, I came up with this. Now we move on to the body. Due to his sheer size, I had to double the amount of wire that I normally use just for structural integrity alone, so he's a bit stiff, but I'm pleased with the results. And despite his simple colour palette, he actually has two different lengths of fur. One of which is surprisingly hard to get my hands on these days, so yes, I saved every scrap I could. And once he's all stitched up, we can unite his head with his body and move on to final touches. The bitter sting of just one thing you said. All the bad. Looks good. And if you're wondering what happened to all of his other eyes, well, here they are. I embedded them onto his armor. I really wish I recorded the making of this, but I was also too busy trying not to inhale resin fumes and gold leaf. It was so messy. But with that said, he's done. Everyone, say hello to Ophanim. To behold, said Special thank you as always to Phildel for letting me use her music in today's video. Her new song, The Procession, is out now, and you can listen to it on Spotify, YouTube, and Apple Music, and find her on all of her social media in the description below. Thanks again. Bye.